Green onions are a social construct, and that's the only piece that is gonna make it into the video. Hi, I'm Phil. Welcome to Pretty Good Cooking, the only show where we find weird things and eat them. It's the only one. It's the only show. This is Burdock Root, and it's big. Tonight on the show, I'm gonna teach you how to make a dish called Tonjiru, which is a pork and miso soup. Comes from Japan. I was inspired to make this dish because of the show Tokyo Stories Midnight Diner, or Midnight Diner Tokyo Stories. Can't remember which one it is. But that's a show that I really enjoyed watching. It's a nice, wholesome show that I like. This was an interesting recipe to prepare for, in that there was lots of things in it that I have really no idea what they are. Or I now know what they are, but I didn't know what they were before. So this was probably gonna, on the scale of replicability, this is gonna be a tough one for a lot of you people if you don't frequent an Asian grocery store, such as we do. Also, because in the spirit of the show, if you haven't seen it, then you should see it. You ask for one biru, and they give you the big bottle. So I've got the Asahi. Yeah, the Asahi here, the beer that's the salaryman beer. Beer for all seasons. You can enjoy it year round. And they always give you like the glass that's smaller than a beer glass. They got a different beer glass. I don't have one of those. So I'm just gonna drink it in a smaller glass. We do our best to replicate exotic treats from around the world, like beer in a small glass. I don't really know what a dry beer means. It's really good. I actually really like that. All right, we gotta start with making dashi. We've made dashi before. Man, I barely remember making that. Okay, so you need some konbu.
Konbu, not kombu, konbu.
Konbu.
A little some of that. And some bonito flakes. These are, in fact, the exact ingredients from the last time we made this stuff, so I think it's probably a couple years old.
What are those?
Bonito flakes.
What are those?
They're not bonito flakes?
Bonito. Well, bonito means pretty.
You put some pretty flakes in your dinner.
And we're gonna put some water on that. Should measure this or something, but I'm sure the flavors of those ingredients will end up in the water, thus making a stock.
It's stinky.
Stink of fish.
I got this heating up in the back.
Looks like it's cooling down to me.
Wrong. It's incorrect.
Dummy.
Next up, I'm gonna peel a little bit of ginger. We're gonna cook this with the pork. I got pork belly, and it's already thinly sliced, which is nice. That's it right there. It's sitting in water. And I am going to mince the ginger. I'm gonna do it gingerly.
Probably made that joke
before. Sorry, guys. I just assume I've already said everything I have to say on the show. That it's all recycled material now. Like, literally every episode is just cobbled together footage of other dishes we've made, and we're just remixing them. Okay, in a skillet, heat it up, pretty high heat. Put a little dab of sesame oil. No jokes there. No jokes to be made. And let it heat up, and prepare your pork.
So it's already thinly sliced, which is actually what you want.
That looks like bacon. Looks like bacon that hasn't been cured. So we're gonna cut it kind of into bite-sized pieces from where it's at right now. This is 3/4 of a pound. You don't really need too much of this because it's thinly sliced, so you're gonna have some plenty of pieces in your soup. And if it was thawed, I would be happy. But it's frozen, so I am neutral. Just kidding, I'm happy.
So once that pan heats up, we'll get that frying with the ginger. And then once that's going, basically we're just gonna be like peeling and chopping all the other pieces of the soup. And I got good buddy Kevin here to assist me with the peeling process.
So I'm gonna go ahead and pop in my ginger and give that just a moment to get fragrant. And then I will pop in my pork, which I'll have to break up as it thaws. I feel like a big part of the Japanese cooking process is like the spirit of artisanship and, you know, like doing simple things really well and that kind of stuff. And although I appreciate those values, wouldn't be our show if I didn't, like, you know, f it up somehow. Cut corners, you know.
Like we do here in America.
All right, so I suppose now Kevin will peel things and I'll chop them most likely. But Kevin's left, so we'll start without him. I don't know where he went. But we'll start with a daikon. I'm pretty sure we've worked with daikon before.
Oh yeah, we definitely have.
Yeah, Saigon daikon. My
dong.
So we need a good piece of this. Probably say
3 inches or so. 3 inches of daikon. And a couple of carrots here. Just have Kevin peel those. Probably two will do.
Welcome back, Kevin. Kevin's coming to peel.
What should I peel first?
The daikon and the carrots.
You peel it.
Next up is Satoimo, which is a baby taro root. I don't really know a lot about these things, so like, what information can I give you? I was able to find them in a grocery store. That's all I know so far.
Well, we gotta peel those too.
We're using two of those. And then also, we've got the burdock root, which is just comically large. We're only gonna use half of it. I don't know what the f- I'm gonna do with the other half. So there's that. I suppose we should unwrap it. Oh! This is weird. Pork smells nice. It's a cute browning though. And we can get our Dutch oven heating up. Probably a medium-ish heat. And I'm going to thinly slice this onion. Just a regular white onion. And this we will cook first in the Dutch oven. Did you know that all of the letters in the word onion can be found in the words often, oh no, sorry, I'm sorry. Oxygen, nitrogen, iodine, oxfate, that's not a word. Osteoporosis, necritude, Nigeria. They're all there, you can count them.
Onion's looking a little wonky.
Ah, f*** it.
All right, pork's cooked, but I think we want to get it a little more brown. And we'll get a neutral oil. I have a sunflower oil here in our Dutch oven. And we'll pop the onions in.
All right, so for the bigger vegetables, like the daikon and the
Satoimo,
we're gonna cut them into essentially quarters and then thinly slice them, such as I'm doing now. And for the, I guess, for lack of a better word, skinnier vegetables, like the carrots, we're gonna do half moons. So really just in half and then similar slices.
Ooh,
pork belly is starting to render down, so it should start browning pretty quickly. You see it's already starting to a bit. So for the sake of my ease, I'm gonna first chop it in half. It's kind of tough. Feels fibrous. Hopefully it cooks down well.
Doesn't taste like really anything.
Tastes like it came right out of the ground.
Not bad.
The onions are a little cooked down. We'll go ahead and throw in the vegetables we have thus far. I need to get that taro. I'm gonna probably not cook this pork much more. This looking nice.
Ooh, it's like milky.
A little bit slimy here, so you gotta be careful when chopping. We're gonna also quarter this, cut it similarly to the daikon as such. A little taste.
Yep, it's taro.
Also not a lot of flavor on it on its own. It's a little bit sweet. Just a kind of a hint of sweetness to it. The texture kind of reminds me of coconut that hasn't been desiccated.
Taro's good. Mix all of it.
Our pork is done, so we're gonna go ahead and turn the heat off that. Got some nice browning. Not everything's totally brown, but I mean, this looks about as good as we're gonna get it. So we'll just leave that. We can drain the fat off. I'm not gonna bother with that right now. And make sure these are stirred. And I'll be back when I figure out what I need to do next.
I don't know.
I've been informed that the next step is for me to drink more. I'm being forced to sample this chew high, which I've sampled before and I know that I don't like it. But apparently you've not seen me do this on film, so it's worth preserving my priceless reaction to premium malt beverages. I hate malt beverages. They taste bad. I don't want it. I'm just sick with my beer. I'll drink more eventually, I'm sure. Look, are you happy? Is this what you want?
I feel like that's what you drink when you're 17 and then you puke everywhere. It's not good.
All right, got some shiitake mushrooms here. I think we can put them in a hole. I think they're small enough. It'll be fun. And the weirdest shit of the day is the Konnyaku. There's a yam cake. It's gelatinous and looks f***ing weird. Look at that. Blub, 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 blub. Bulb. So I'm gonna pop that open. Like, what the f***, Japan? What is this? Why did you make this? Oh god, it's even worse in my hand. Oh shit. Oh, it's so f***ing weird here. You gotta hold this. This is f***ing weird. I only need half of it, so I'll let Kevin play with the other half. What in the f***?
Oh god. It's like an alien egg sack. Oh shit. Oh no!
Oh no.
Don't worry about it, it's gone. It's gone.
Did you need that?
Nope, only needed half, so. Alright, so it's just do some rectangles of this. These look like the material that like fake bait for fishingers made out.
Oh yeah, totally.
I gotta eat it. Man, that is rubbery and tastes like nothing. You know, I think I might chop these into smaller pieces. Cause I can't imagine that big of a piece would be pleasant. Oh Christ, oh, that's so strange.
You got tadpoles in your hands.
Some amphibious life form died for this. In they go, and also to my cheese.
Yum, yum, yum.
Dashi's like not really done, but it's close enough and I don't wanna wait, so. Weird shit today, man. I just thought it looked like a wholesome pork soup, not fish bait soup. You know what this soup needs? Some rubber. Strain the dashi. Dashi. I think I'm gonna dump it in the pork. You could drain the fat, but I feel like there's just nothing else in this. So, well, we'll put in a little bit of the fat. We won't make too much of an effort to get rid of it, but we won't just dump it in. And that is kind of a lot of fat. Yeah, it's fine.
It's fine.
Oh Christ, I've already eaten so many weird things in this meal. I'm just confused. It all looks so good, except those jelly pieces. What the f***? All right, so we're gonna hit it with the dashi llama. All right, so in goes the dashi. I'm just gonna kind of fill it most of the way up. And we'll give it a big old mix. And we'll let it stew about 20 minutes. That smells super good. So we'll be back in a little bit. I gotta get this simmering. You know what that looks like, right? Little bubbles in the pot. Bubbles, and just ignore the jelly. Soup simmered down. All right, it's like 20 minutes. I don't know. Maybe longer. And now everything's tender, which is desirable. We need to reduce the heat to the lowest possible. We don't want it to boil anymore. Next up, we're gonna cut some green onions. And these will be a garnish. These green onions are in fact organic. They are organic. I've had one big beer and it's done me in. Next up, we're gonna chop up some tofu. We got half a block and we're gonna slip these into the soup. This is firm tofu, just regular firm. Yeah! Now we gotta put a load of miso in this, and then I think it's done. We're using miso aways. Awase. Miso aways!
Miso aways, my boys! Miso
aways! Anyways, alright, we gotta put 5 tablespoons of miso into this. And you're supposed to like use a strainer, like mix it up so that it makes you make sure it's dissolved. But I'm having a hard time because there's not that much liquid. This method. Let's just dump it in and mix it up. And I'll use a ladle or some shit to ensure proper mixture ratio. And I'm only putting in 4 scoops, but each one's been a hefty scoop, so I think that makes 5. That's American math for you if you didn't know. Alright, home stretch, baby. So really just really mix it up. I read you're supposed to do that strainer method and not let it boil because miso loses flavor if you boil it. I don't know if that's true. Maybe it is. Probably true because someone spent the time to write it. I don't know like who would be spreading conspiracies about miso losing flavor if it wasn't true. Alright, okay. Well, let's finish this up. Get yourself a bowl. And we will ladle some soup into the bowl. Great, I got lots of jelly in mine. Great, and we will garnish with a little green onion topping. You put them in the middle, make your dish look fancy. And it's a very simple dish, so it lends itself well to Shichimi Togarashi from Kroger. I'm just gonna go ahead and hit it with the spice because I know it needs it.
Arigato, Kroger-san!
All right, there's our nice little soup. Looks great.
Save it with some rice.
It's tasting time. What could it be like? It's delicious. It tastes like pork and miso. Like there's not a whole lot else going on. Let's try some of that jelly shit. That's better than it was, like, cold. That's not too bad. Well, guys, that's how you make it. Really interesting dish, never had anything like it. Lots of weird things in there that don't taste like anything. If you haven't watched Midnight Dinner, go watch all of it on Netflix. Netflix. I am not sponsored by Netflix. Maybe you'll work out better than Kroger did. Arigato, Netflix-san! Okay, bye!